Nicholas Jackson has had an interesting start to life at Chelsea so far. Here are some key facts about his performances. Participation in matches. Nicholas Jackson has played 23 matches in total during the 2023-2024 season. This is a statistic that could be surprising to some fans, considering the fact that he has not been the greatest in many games, so it would have been a surprise to know that even then he was still getting a lot of minutes, getting so much matches. But obviously this is a stat that, you know, some fans will obviously feel a sense of, why was he still playing in matches where we had Broha, we had other players like Washington who could have got a minute, probably gotten an opportunity to show what he can do and if he's good enough as well. Goals. He has scored 9 goals in all competitions. So comparing the 23 matches, 9 goals, obviously he does have some assists as well, but those assists doesn't necessarily make it look as good. But for a striker, or for a forward rather, that has just come into the league, it's his first season, 9 goals isn't entirely bad. But obviously we know that the misses that he's had, the opportunities that he would have blundered and he would have flopped and not convert, obviously doesn't make the narrative good as well, because he could have had more goals. Minutes played is accumulated to a total of 1,843 minutes on the field. He works as a center forward as his position, and at the moment, according to Transfer Market, his market value is 35 million, something that isn't much of a surprise. And when you look at his market value and what Chelsea would have paid for him, it's not bad, you know, it's not a bad investment per se. I mean, if he doesn't succeed, which I'm going to say from now, I believe he will succeed, it's an investment that was worth it, because he's not expensive, he's not 80 million, he's not 90 million or higher than that. It was pretty cheap for a striker or a forward, so it's not much of a surprise. He represented Senegal obviously recently in the African Cup of Nations, where he would have played 7 international matches, but he wouldn't have scored goals for them, also adding fuel to the fact that they were eliminated quite earlier than the last time and they were competing. Obviously when they won AFCON then, he wouldn't have been an influential player as well then, but you know, he represented Senegal, he came back quite earlier than some people probably would have believed, based on Senegal being one of the favorites to make it further in the competition, and they actually finished. Overall, Jackson has been an active part of Chelsea's team. He's contributed some important goals as well. So despite not scoring much goals, he has contributed some important goals. His ability as a striker will be crucial to Chelsea's continued success this season. The fact that he's actually done quite well as a wide player, we can always return to the most recent match against Aston Villa at the time of recording, where he would have scored the second goal against Aston Villa at Villa Park with a bullet header. You know, sometimes he's missed some headers, but that goal that he scored, it showed conviction, it showed a good conversion, it showed a striker or a player that actually knows how to hit the ball with their head and put it in the back of the net. Being his first season, as I would have mentioned, he has been average. He could have done better in terms of scoring and taking his chances, as I would have mentioned as well. When you look at how he took his goal against Aston Villa, you know, it really shows that if he would have done that regularly, then you never know, maybe Chelsea would have also been able to convert more, get more goals, probably be higher than up the table. But this is not me saying that he is the reason why we're not higher up on the table. Our attack, our entire attack is a part of that reason, and also our defense that hasn't helped us as well. You know, there has been shaky moments as well. Fair to say that his best position is probably as part of a front two or a wide in a front three. Nkunku being one of the only options that can actually be trusted consistently to play in a front line, we're leading the line, could perhaps give him that confidence. Obviously there has been talks of probably Nkunku supporting him would make it better, and I don't believe we should rely on one player solely to make that impact so that we can get the best out of another player. However, it has shown that having him play as a wide player as well, being supported or not being the focal point, has made his game better. There's a lot of room for improvement with regards to his performances overall. So in a sense, you know, I'm like I said before, I'm going to reiterate the fact that I believe that he'll make it at Chelsea, but he's had an average season so far. And it is fair to just simply say that and, you know, just say it for what it is. He's had an average season. He's not been the brightest figure for Chelsea, but he's not the worst player. It's fair to say that. Cheers.